In this video, we're going to show you how to go through, view, and complete action items that have been assigned to you, either by name or by your role within the company. There are several places that you can actually go to see action items that you need to be working on. The first is by going into your dashboard and clicking on action items. This is what I call the wide but shallow view. It is a wide view across every single open claim that you have responsibility for performing action items on, but it is only the tasks that are immediately able to be completed that the prerequisites have been fulfilled. It's not past action items and it's not speculative forward-facing action items. It's the here and now across everything you should be doing. So in your action item tabs, you're going to see several settings that you can choose up front. And we have gone over this in other videos. But here you can see all action items across your entire team. You can see just your specific action items. And then there's this button here that says explicitly assigned. That means if you were assigned by name to a specific action item, it will show up here. If you deselect this checkbox, you're going to see that I have action items that are assigned to me, but assigned to me in the capacity of a role that I am performing on a specific claim. So on this first claim up here, I see that I am assigned to this claim as an adjuster, and there's an action item that adjusters need to perform on this claim. So adjuster equals Lynette, and that's why I see it. Also on this second one down here, you'll see this particular action item was tagged for the executive or for the owner of the company to be able to work on this. So that's why I'm seeing it, because in this instance, executive equals Lynette. This is helpful if you have multiple adjusters, multiple executives, etc., that if you don't necessarily want to give it to one person, but anyone in that role that can pick it up and answer it, and it will show up that way. Of course, action items, if they are red, they are overdue. If they are reverse red, they are critical and overdue. They are sortable. They show claim phase, due date. So most people will sort where the oldest is on the top and kind of go through it that way. We have the ability to check to see if we are waiting for anything. So if there is a possibility that this action item will go overdue, we may want to sit and document why this action item is about to go overdue. So if we're sending a proof of loss to the insurance carrier, but our client has not yet notarized it, that is something significant that should be documented. So if you ever get called up at it in the future, it is there in writing rather than relying on your memory. Notes are the same. Of course, you can scroll left to right, see loss address, policyholder, when this action item was created, how old it is. Once you get past a certain point, we don't give you exact days. This is really old. Data loss and the carrier. Now, of course, you can make these columns go wherever you want, shorten them if you need to. You can also group action items by claim. So you know that if you're going to work on a specific claim, you have two or three action items. You can see that ahead of you. And that you can also do critical only, which is all that I have here. So I'm going to do all action items. Sort them just so we can see, and you can see the ones in black are, we still have time to complete them. We only want to see criticals, and we want to see criticals grouped by claim. So you can kind of mix and match as you see. There is also an options option here that you can select the columns that you'd like to display. If you don't particularly in your job role care about the carrier or the loss address or how old it is, etc., you can turn those off. Of course, you have the ability to export and get this information out all at once if you choose to. Just remember on the bottom, you can show all, auto, or group how many you'd like to see. I currently have 5 pages of action items. If I click all, I'm going to see 44 rows, which means there are 44 active action items across my entire organization that need to be completed. Another place to view action items is in the claim itself. So if we go and open a claim and take a look at the action items tab, we're going to see all completed, successfully completed action items, some more detailed information on it, and if there are currently any outstanding or current to execute action items, they will show up here as well. So here you can see call carrier added October 21st, 2020, assigned to the adjuster, and this is who completed it on the date. And there was also a note set on that. If you click on the action item, it will give you the ability to look for more information as well as waiting for assign or reassign and add notes. This is important right here because even though we are assigning it to the adjuster role on a particular claim, there may be one or two adjusters, or even if there's just one, we want to know who completed and clicked the actual button to say that this task was completed. As you can see in here, our best practices is that if there is an action item with a number in front of it, that it is a standard boilerplate action item for the type of workflow that that claim exists in and why it was opened. So if this claim was opened as a new claim, it will open and run and execute the new claim workflow. If this claim was opened as a new claim, but then had to be switched over to appraisal, you do not go back and change the reason why you opened the claim to appraisal. There will be action items built into the systems to say if a new claim goes into appraisal, this is how you deal with it. The great feature about this is that you just do business as usual. If something changes and a claim goes off of its preferred path of execution, Claim Wizard's action items will walk you correctly through the path and the deadlines and the escalation paths that you need to follow for that claim in order to get it through appraisal, as an example, or reinspection or partial payment or anything along those lines, that you don't have to think about what should I be doing next. Claim Wizard has that figured out for you. But something that is very useful up here is the action items, what we call the on-demand action items. And those are generally the ones that don't have numbers in front of them. They will not have an escalation path. These are used more in the capacity of, say, a post-it note that you may be passing across team members, a text message, replaces email, etc. So instead of you trying to call someone and text someone and email someone on your team to either ask them a question or ask them to call someone or ask for a report, you can simply put it in as an action item, your preferred due date, and some other information. It will notify them, and when they complete it, it gets automatically documented and recorded in the system. For example, we can ask to, say, call the homeowner, and we would like you to call the homeowner by today, and we think the adjuster should call the homeowner, and I'm going to mark it as critical, so you mark the flag, and you hit save. Once that's done, you can see due today, call homeowner. I literally just got that notification in my email. Here's the notification that I just received in my email, and it says call homeowner, basic information about the claim. If I click this, it will jump me right back into Claim Wizard and show me that claim information. Of course, if you want to add more notes regarding this, you can click this and say, you know, the owner found more damage. This way, when your adjuster calls, they know what they're calling about. Save it, and it's done. When that adjuster gets the notification on Claim Wizard or on the Claim Wizard mobile application, they will simply, you know, call the homeowner, do whatever they need to do, and click done, that it is done. Everything gets documented automatically. It is searchable. It is exportable. It is your written diary conversation logs of everything that you do on Claim Wizard.